Hello, my name is Bill and welcome to MindYourCrypto. Today I have Vechain Vet update. Let's see what it needs to do in order to go upwards, guys. And of course, we will take it step by step to the technical analysis to make possible price prediction. If you like the content, please help me with clicking the like button, subscribing, hitting the bell button to turn all the notifications on and share. So here we go, having the 16 cents, 16 to 17 cents as our support level, but I don't think we will go soon here, guys. I believe that we are about to make a reversal head and shoulders pattern, left shoulder, the head, and of course the right shoulder that will go eventually upwards, hoping to break through the 19 cents, the previous swing high here, because if we break this, where we found huge sell pressure here, as you can see, if we break this, then we will go upwards, breaking through some important resistance levels for Vechain. That's what we need to do, and of course we need to break through some resistance levels in order to make sure we will be seeing higher highs and higher lows. We will discuss furthermore in the price analysis, but we have one important thing here, the MACD. The MACD, guys, what we need to see is possible higher highs and higher lows for the blue line to go something like this and the signal line to follow behind. Even if it goes above the blue line, we won't care, because these are very healthy correction in the 4-hour frame, because it happens when the commodity channel index goes above 100, when we have an overbought situation, and therefore that's why you see sometimes the blue line going above the signal line, beyond the signal line. But what we need to see here is to stop seeing lower highs and lower lows like here, guys. We need to see higher highs and higher lows like before, like from April, that we saw higher highs and higher lows April 2021 until we reached the 17th April, this top, then we fell down all the way, moving upwards again, falling down again. Now we need to see higher highs and higher lows, eventually same as before. We stopped at this support level, this was actually pretty good, and of course the volume here, we need not to see a declining volume, we need to see more volume for Vechain in order to go upwards again. So let's see, guys, Vechain against USDT in the 4-hour frame, but for the Common Channel Index and the RSI. What we need to see here is, of course, go above the Common Channel Index, go above the 100. Once it goes above the 100, guys, it will soon go like this. But what we need to see actually afterwards, it is making higher lows. That's what we need to see. We don't care for some minor corrections during the day. We just want to see, for now, for Vechain, higher lows in every index possible. For the Common Channel Index, for the RSI as well, what we need to see here is surpassing some important resistance levels, going down again, then going upwards again. That's what we need to see for Vechain and for the RSI, for the Commodity Channel Index. According to the SSL channel, guys, the green line is above the red line, so we are having a buying opportunity. Okay, as you can see here, when this happens, we are having a buying opportunity, but this is not always the case, because here it told us that we have buying opportunity, but eventually we fell down for the short term. But I think that we might have a buying opportunity, I will explain it later. Let's go to Vechain against USDT in the daily frame. And the reason we might have a buying opportunity is this area, guys, for Vechain. We are going now into the gray zone, we don't have any oversold situation yet, and therefore, not a buying opportunity, but I think we have, because I believe Commodity Channel Index will go upwards on the daily frame. So by going upwards, this means the price will go upwards as well. And if I go back to see other times that it went beyond minus 100, you can see here it went upwards. You can see here it went upwards again and again in the daily frame, and again it went upwards. Even if it does something like this and then goes down more, then it will eventually recover in the next days. So you might wait as well 10 days, but for now, I believe that we might have a good buying opportunity according to the daily frame. Even if we see lower highs, eventually we will be seeing higher highs. Okay, so this might be a good buying opportunity for Vechain, but we need to do something that I will explain on Vechain against Bitcoin chart. However, for the MACD, what we need to see here is a more horizontal angle for the blue line, and eventually going upwards when the signal line will go beyond the blue line and it will follow the blue line. So we need to think a bullish recross here between the lines like we had back on 5 April, and of course some further distance between those lines like here, guys, like this for example. So right now, where are we? According to the RSI, we don't have any oversold situation, and of course we are between 30 and 70. What we care for about right now is to make higher highs, higher lows. Eventually, if we don't make this, then we won't be able to say that we are moving upwards. We might move a bit downwards. Okay, so we need to see higher highs and higher lows in every aspect, including the Komodo Channel Index. So yeah, according to the Komodo Channel Index, we have a buying opportunity. However, what we want to see, what is the most important thing, and of course the Bollinger Bands were beyond, we are inside the Bollinger Bands, but we are on approaching the bottom line of the Bollinger Bands, as you can see here, guys. But what we need to see is actually this important chart, Vechain against Bitcoin. So if we see a recross here, guys, if we see a 20-day recross between the 50-day and the 20-day, if we see a recross, that means that Vechain will go against Bitcoin, because we expect Bitcoin to make some lower lows and lower highs. If it goes like this, if we have a bullish cross here, then we can go against Bitcoin, and then we can move maybe against Bitcoin, but we need some further distance. We need this cross and we need the yellow line to go even further above, while the red line remains more horizontal for its angle. So what we need here is to see this bullish recross, and then eventually we can go against Bitcoin and we can move upwards for the USDT as well. So, according to the Komodo Channel Index in the 4-hour frame, we are approaching an overbought situation for Vechain against Bitcoin, but what we need to see right now is making low, higher highs, higher lows. We don't care if we just fall down, as long as we will be making higher highs and higher lows, okay? So, even if we don't do that, it is very important to see this for the daily frame. Even in the 4-hour frame, if we move downwards, it's okay, as long as in the daily frame we are going upwards. For the RSI, we don't have any oversold or any overbought situation. However, we are looking better than the Vechain against USDT, because we are moving, we are having higher highs and higher lows, and eventually move to 57 RSI relative strength index. You can see the yellow line when it is inside the purple area. We don't have any overbought or any oversold situations. So right here we go to Vechain against Bitcoin, the daily frame, tell you what I always told you. As long as we keep this price, this support line, guys, I will correlate with blue, then we are fine. And of course, as long as we keep the 20-day MA above the 50-day MA. That's why on the daily frame we are very good. And what we need to see though on the daily frame is not making lower highs. We need to stop to see this. We need to stop, for example, to have a resistance here and go downwards. If we manage to do that, if we manage to see, not to see lower highs and higher lows, and lower lows, sorry guys, then eventually we can see Vechain going against Bitcoin in the short term too. So this is very important, the bullish cross and the distance. It is very, very important, guys, because it prices altcoins that won't move, that will move against Bitcoin, will move upwards. Altcoins that are underperforming against Bitcoin will move downwards. So it is very important to go and move upwards as well. So this is for Vechain against Bitcoin. Let's go to our price analysis. What we need to see here, what we need to see here is to keep actually our lower highs, of course, and our higher lows, sorry, and our higher highs. We need to keep seeing this. As long as we are doing this, we are fine. But first of all, guys, we need to have a price action above the 19 cents. What this will mean? This will mean that if we go above the 19 cents around there, guys, the 19 cents, then we can eventually, break this target and start making higher highs, because this here was our last swing high before we fall. We want to see a reversal head and shoulders pattern, and I think we are there seeing the reversal head and shoulders pattern and maybe going upwards, okay? So first of all, breaking the 19 cents, which I think we will be breaking. Secondly, we need to go and surpass this Fibonacci retracement, the 20 cents, 21, and of course our golden ratio, 22 cents. So these are our price actions, and these are our possible price targets for the short term. Breaking the 19 cents would mean that most likely we will go even above this resistance line, the 19-20 cents, then we might eventually test the 20 to 21 cents. If we can go upwards, then we will be testing the 21 to 22 and so on, as you can see here. So what we need to do is, first of all, we need to see VeChain going against Bitcoin. Secondly, we need to see the VeChain breaking some important resistance levels. For example, guys, sometime on the bullish run, we are going upwards, and when we are below the 200 EMA, the white line here, we are having a buying opportunity if we keep having a bullish situation for an altcoin. So this is the first time after so much time that we are beyond the 200 EMA, the price went downwards. So this might be a good buying opportunity, guys, for the mid long term. For the short term, what we want to see is breaking some higher targets, for example the 19 cents, the 21. I believe, in my personal experience, guys, I believe that we can do it. VeChain can go upwards. It can test some very, very good upward situation resistance levels. And of course, it can break above them. So that's what we need to see. Of course, if we can do this, then we will see eventually the 20-day EMA recrossing with a 50-day exponential moving average. And then we will be seeing a more bullish scenario. Right now, as long as the 50-day EMA is above the signal line, as long as the 50-day EMA is above the 20-day EMA, then we can actually not assume that we will be going upwards. But guys, the charts are telling us that we might have a reversal in the trend and we might go above, we might go upwards, okay? So that's what we need to see for VeChain against USDT. For those who bought at the top, do not worry, guys. Patience is the key for success. You need three things. I repeat that in every video almost, guys. And of course, you need discipline, a buying strategy, and an exit strategy. So for the short term, we need to surpass some important resistance levels in order to be sure that we will be having a buying opportunity. That means clear buying opportunity. It means you minimize the risk. I believe, I'm kind of optimistic, and I believe that we will see on the VeChain the recross here, and we will go upwards, VeChain against Bitcoin, as well as we will see VeChain going upwards because it will move against Bitcoin. It is very important to do that because I believe that Bitcoin will do some lower lows and lower highs. So eventually it will be looking very, very good, especially if we break some important resistance levels. So our next targets are 19 cents, 20 cents. And I think if we can break this, then we can actually move to retest the 20 cents maybe. And we will see about that. I will be making daily updates, guys. It is looking good. As long as we will be making the 200 EMA our support level and we will be moving upwards, it will be all good, guys. And of course, we can move upwards. The key thing here is to be making higher highs, higher lows, especially in the daily frames for the RSI. And of course, guys, in the daily frame for the RSI, in the USDT, and in the commodity channel index. That's what we want to see in order to see VeChain regaining some strength for the short term, mid term, and of course, breaking some important resistance levels. Thank you for joining here. Thank you for watching. Have a fantastic day wherever you are. And of course, stay tuned for many, many more videos, as well as I will post many daily updates, guys, every day. Stay safe from scammers in the comment section. And of course, stay safe in general. Bye.